Okay, there is no doubt that Adobe Generative Fill is an absolute magical and incredible tool in the new versions of Photoshop. However, I have found a strange limitation to it that it almost seems like the AI is trying too hard when you have a clean studio background. You just want to make a clean studio background. You want to extend it because you ran out of paper or something that happens very, very often in a studio shoot. And the AI struggles with that a little bit. I found a hack that works pretty well I want to share with you, and hopefully it helps you when you're out there doing your product photography. Let's go take a look at it. So as you can see here, I have a product, and this is a pretty common thing you're going to experience when you do any time of studio shoot. I had the paper shot. I did have to take it at an angle, and I just ran out of paper space, and I had to have a bounce down here. I want to extend it so it doesn't look like you see these things. Now, if you use Generative Fill, you may discover some interesting things. I'm going to use Generative Fill. I'm just going to go ahead and get rid of this little area right here, and I'm going to go ahead and hit Generative Fill. Okay, and as you can see, this is a classic problem here that I've encountered doing this with Adobe Generative Fill. It's trying too hard. Look, it's trying to add in a backdrop. You can see it's adding a plant in there. It's adding these weird corners because Photoshop's doing, the AI is doing what it thinks it should be and thinks that, well, hey, the light naturally falls off there. That's what we want to do. That's not what we want to do with the studio. We want this to look like it's on an infinite space. So I want to show you the hack that I found to make this work. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go and hide this layer. I'm going to go to my background layer. I'm just going to hit Command J. I'm going to duplicate it just so I have a duplicate layer there. So my original is very safe. And I go back to an old tried and true formula. I'm going to go ahead and click this part that I want to get rid of right here. And now check this out. I'm going to come up here to Content Aware Fill. So I'm going to go to Edit, Content Aware Fill, and I'm going to do this. This is a pre-AI thing that we can use. And you can see it's not going to necessarily give me, I'm going to kind of get rid of some of this over here because I don't want to sample over here. I'm going to use this. And what it's going to do, it's not going to give me the greatest result ever, but it's going to give me a different base level for the AI to work with. And that's going to be an important factor in playing out with this. So as you can see, I have my Content Aware Fill here, and you know, it's not great. It does fix the problem. It's just a little sloppy. It samples some weird pixels, but it looks a lot better than this. But now here's the key. I'm going to take this Content Aware Fill thing. I'm going to combine it with my original layer. I'm just going to Command D and combine those two layers. And now I'm going to use this as the base level to extend my backdrop. And now that I've got this as a base, I'm going to click over here. I'm just going to go ahead and I'm just going to select this again. I'm going to do a Generative Fill from this. I'm going to generate it. And let's see. Ooh, okay. That's a pretty good one. And you can see right there, it's not perfect, but it's now starting to get me a cleaner base backdrop. So once again, I can start building my base off of this. I'm going to go ahead and now come down here on the bottom. I'm going to do the same thing with this piece of paper here on the bottom. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do a Content Aware Fill. And when I do this, I'm not trying to get it perfect. I just wanted to get so I have a different base level to work with Photoshop. And you can see there, Content Aware Fill does a pretty darn good job right off the base here. But I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to combine these together here. I'm going to combine this together too. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do a new, let's see if we can get a different Generative Fill there. Yeah, it's starting to look a little better there. There you go. And now you can see that's before, that's after. So this gives me a much, much more what I would consider nice professional looking thing there. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to combine it all together just for the heck of it. I'm still not 100% sold on this over here. So I might just try and do one more selection over here. Let's try and get a nice big broad area. Do Generative Fill. So as you can see, it took me just a few times to do that. But what we have here now is a much better feel. And you can see just, you know, that's what we started with and that's what we ended up with. So now I have a much more natural kind of infinite studio space, and that really, really helped. Now, if you don't want to use Content Aware Fill and just want to use Generative Fill, there is a way I found in the selection process that can help you get a much better Generative Fill if you just want to deal with that and not worry about Content Aware Fill. And that deals with where you select. Now, in Generative Fill, we're told, you know, give yourself a couple of pixels here on the side. But what I found, if you want to get a kind of infinite backdrop extension like this, sample much further over. So instead of sampling here on the edge, I'm going to come much further into my composition. I'm going to sample this far in. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to do my Generative Fill from this as a base. And it's not perfect, you can see, but I'll go over there. Ah, there you go. I think two was pretty good. Yeah, I think that came out actually really good. I'm going to go ahead, take that, and then I'm going to do the same thing down here on the bottom. I'm just going to select much further away, so I basically take more of that as a backdrop. I'm going to do a generative fill there. And yeah, I mean, that looks pretty good too, if you ask me. And that was a really good way to do it really fast. And that saves you having to do that content aware fill step. I'll be honest, I actually did a number of these pictures over the weekend. And I did find adding that content aware fill as a base did give me more consistent results. But it's just one of those things. I think a lot of photographers out there don't necessarily need to add mountainscapes and stuff to picture. This feels like a very realistic thing that generative fill can do. And you can see here just how nice. I mean, look at that. I mean, that's before and after. Generative fill can really give you that nice thing. You can use that AI to your advantage, extend those backdrops. Just a trick that I think you're going to really want to know. Anyway, I'd love to hear what you have to say with this. Leave me any notes and comments down below. And yeah, I'd rather keep on shooting. Yeah, talk to you soon.